Hey, what's good, you guys? It's your boy, SJ Kid, the first Black Super Saiyan who ever I've on this planet. I'm back here with another video. Look, this is part 5. Hopefully, we'll be done with this at part 6. Hopefully. Man, let's go ahead and get this. First thing, we gotta go ahead and rack out. Let me go ahead and pop this thing up here. Pop that pussy like porn stars. Let's go.
I'm gonna turn the ship around.
Yeah. Now he wants to run. Great.
I want to protect the stone.
And I want you to thank me now. Go ahead, I'm listening.
For what? Nearly blasting me into space?
Who just saved your magical ass? Me.
I seriously don't know how you fit your head into that helmet.
Admit it. You should have ducked out when I told you to. I tried to bench you. You refused.
Unlike everyone else in your life, I don't work for you.
And due to that fact, we're now in a flying donut, billions of miles from Earth with no backup.
I'm backup.
No, you're still away. The adults are talking.
I'm sorry, I'm confused as to the relationship here. I mean, what is he, your...
Listen. Tony, Doctor Strange. That's what I hate about this fucking scene. Doctor Strange is the wackiest hero in this movie, but the most strongest hero. You just said here, I want to protect the stone. He said in this scene, if anything happens to both of you, I do not care. This stone goes above both of you, and I will not help either of you. So basically, based off that, this fool, why don't you just make a portal and go back to Earth? You can travel to the mirror dimension, but you can't make no portal to get back to Earth. That's how that works, right? He can't make a portal to get back to Earth because plot. Because he's not this powerful and he can't do it. He can only go to certain places. Fuck out of here. Listen.
6 years since he sent an army to New York and now he's back. And I don't know what to do. So I'm not so sure if it's a better plan to fight him on our turf or his, but you saw what they did, what they can do. At least on his turf, he's not expecting it. So I say we take the fight to him, Doctor.
Take the fight to him on a foreign planet that you don't know nothing about. There's a reason he is not the leader of the Avengers.
Stark, we go to him. But you have to understand, if it comes to saving you, or the kid, or the time stone, I will not hesitate to let either of you die. I can't, because the universe depends on it.
Okay, so, he said this. He said, when it comes to this stone, I won't put this above. This stone goes above both of you, right? He met Iron Man and Spider-Man today in this movie. This movie takes place in the span of a day. Actually, 2 days. No, a day. 2 days a day, it don't matter. And, Tony somehow convinced Doctor Strange that, oh my god, they can do this, this, and that. Either way, you can either have it come on the home turf, or you can either have it come on the happen over there. Either way, you got the Infinity Stone on Earth. You really think Captain America, Hawkeye, who else? Hawkeye, Ant-Man, Black Widow, War Machine are going to be able to stop Thanos if you guys can. And they don't, nobody knows this because Tony, stupid ass, didn't pick up the phone and say, beep, 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 yo, something about to happen real quick. I gotta go in and fight this fight. We'll try to link up with us here as fast as you can. If you can't, just get here as fast as you can. Whack, bro. Weak. Next scene, bruh. Best scene in this movie.
I thought you might be hungry.
Nigga, fuck your pudding. Toss that shit. Yo, pudding, nigga. Got me messed up. Freak that pudding, bruh. No, I don't want that shit. Freak him. Thanos is a weirdo. I don't know what goes through his head. Thanos is that kind of person that, like, he's that person that stays in an abusive relationship and you ask them, why are you still here? And they give you some sort of, I'm scared. Thanos is like that, is that complicated. That's how complicated Thanos is. He is that complicated as a person. Check this out.
I saved you.
No. No. We were happy on my home planet.
Uh-huh.
Going to bed hungry, scrounging for scraps.
Mm-hmm.
Your planet was on the brink of collapse. Yeah. I'm the one who stopped that.
Oh.
You know what's happened since then?
Uh-huh.
The children born have known nothing but full bellies and clear skies. It's a paradise.
Wait, Thanos. I thought in Guardians 1, Gamora was the last of her kind, as it said on her profile in Guardians 1, that she's the last of her kind. What happened to that? What happened to that, Thanos? Thanos, what happened, bruh? Russo's, James Gunn, give us some answers, bro. In Guardians 1, she was the last of her kind. In this movie, Thanos only killed half. And let's talk about Thanos here. His ideology is all messed up in the head, bro. It don't make no sense. Does Thanos not know that you're going to have some people that are poor and some people that are rich? That's how life goes. You're going to have a stronger opposition here and you're going to have the weaker opposition. It always going to be like that. Nobody is ever going to be equal because everybody is complicated, everybody is unfair, and everybody is biased, bruh. This world is never going to be equal. We can work to make it equal, but it ain't going to be equal. Thanos' ideology is BS. So basically, Thanos is going to kill more people, snap his finger, which will separate families, and in doing so, when this happens, when he separates more families, he expects people to listen to his message and articulate it and take it as, we need to stop being greedy. But no. Thanos is randomly killing so many people at a time. So he snaps his finger, boom, 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 and randomly people die. If you don't die in the snap, potentially your daughter may die, or your son may die, your grandmother may die, and you really think at the end of all this, Thanos is going to come to you, now do you all know your lesson? Do you think they're all going to just listen? Nah, they're going to say, freak you, bro. You killed my grandpappy, my grandmammy, my auntie Jemima. Y'all crazy. Thanos, get up out of here. That's crazy, bro. That is crazy. I know Thanos is somewhat crazy, but he has no origin to establish that. He has no origin to establish that because before Titan died, this man had the belief that half needed to die. What put those dark thoughts in his head? Where did those dark thoughts come from? What's that origin of that? Of how he, before Titan, wanted to kill half. What put those dark thoughts in his head that I just want to kill half? And half needs to go. What put those thoughts in his head? Let me know, because that is not in Infinity War. And best believe that will not be in Avengers 4. He showed up in 4 films already, including Avengers Infinity War. So basically, if they didn't show his origin in the first film, which was Avengers 1, which this is what they should have done if they wanted to explain Thanos further. Each post-credit scene you put him in, explain something about him. Show him during his childhood doing something. Boom, boom, boom. It can be a 5-minute clip of him doing something in his childhood. Boom, that's over in that movie. Next movie, you have the Avengers story, right? Boom, boom, boom. Get the post-credits scene. You show 5 minutes of Thanos just doing stuff in his childhood. Boom, you building up to it. Guardians 1, they show Thanos, right? They didn't show him post-credits scene, but they show Thanos in the little 5-minute scene of him flexing his cock, flexing his power. Where's the backstory? You keep telling me that he's feared. But why? How is he so powerful in the MCU? Why is he so OP? How can he hold 6 Infinity Stones? What is a Titan? People keep on saying he's a mad Titan. What is a Titan in the MCU? What are Titans? If they don't explain that in Avengers 4, well, it's too late now at this point. You should have explained it in Avengers Infinity War, Thanos' movie. But nah, they took out 30 minutes of Thanos' origin to decrease the time, which was needed because this is the villain you've been building to. And this is top MCU villain to everybody. Top 3. This is in their top 3s. Thanos is top MCU villain because he's basically powerful. Because he's powerful. People want to put that power, and he got no backstory to hold him together. This man is basically... Gosh, I was just thinking about this. Damn, I was just thinking about something earlier when I was playing Red Dead 2. Alright, next scene, because people were very confused about this scene.
Because you did.
And you lied.
And you lied.
Probably the best dialogue from Thanos in this scene.
Probably did. Because you lied.
Thanos, bro, he built. Look at the muscles, bro. Mm. Alright, bro, we almost there. We crunching this. We killing it, bro. We killing it. Come on. Next scene, bro. Alright, this is the scene right here. Fuck this scene, bro. There's only one funny line in this scene that I can possibly accept.
Beginnings of one. It's pretty simple. We draw him in, pin him down, get what we need. Definitely don't want to dance with this guy. We just want the gauntlet. Are you yawning? In the middle of this while I'm breaking it down? Huh? Did you hear what I said?
Stop listening.
Oh, now Tony wants to be serious. They was joking and making Squidward earlier. You know, I'm just saying. If you're going to have a tone and have something be serious, have that be your movie. This movie got more than 10 jokes in this movie, bruh. More than 10 jokes in this movie, bruh. And this supposed to be a serious film. This is an action comedy. This is an action motherfucking comedy, bruh. It's not a serious film like that. It's an action comedy. Yeah, the issue is serious, but the only person that's serious up in this movie is Captain America, Black Panther, and Thanos. Everybody else over here cracking jokes. Maybe borderline Doctor Strange, but you know, he was cracking some jokes that was unneeded earlier, bro. Nah, he was trying. It was really Tony. Tony was the one putting him into the joking. It's when that scene, when Tony came in and he's over here cracking jokes, and I'm over when he put his hand on the freaking that pot thingy in Doctor Strange's sanctum, and I'm like, bro, shut the fuck up. We really about to throw some comedy in here while you trying to explain why Thanos is coming? For real? Yeah, alright, we had 19 movies of this. Can we finally take some things serious, bro? I get it, but shut the fuck up.
After you said we need a plan.
Okay, Mr. Clean's on his own page. You need to see, not winging it isn't really what they do.
Kick names, what exactly is it that they do?
Kick names, take ass.
Yes. Mantis is hot, bro. Look at her. Look at that face.
All right, just get her.
That's what you get, Tony. For you cracking all them jokes, you should be totally fine with this. Now Tony wants to be serious? Freak out of here, bro.
Over here, please. Mr. Lord, can you get your folks to serve?
Alright, but next scene. This is the biggest scene we gotta talk about. This is the scene I honestly hate in this. Tony's total plot device, bro. And I'll talk about it.
Math is blowing my mind.
Excuse me? But does your friend often do that?
Ooh, do you often do that, man?
Strange!
Good at it.
You alright? Be back, Jeremy.
He was spazzing, what was bro. That?
Went for it.
He busted that nut, and then the girl, she kept on sucking, bro. And she, oh my god. That's what that was. That's what that was.
Time to view alternate futures, to see all the possible outcomes of the coming conflict. How many did you see? 14,605.
14,605. One. Let's talk about this, bro. Let's talk about this. Doctor Strange, why didn't you do this earlier? Why did you not do this when you was at the Inner Sanctum? The Sanctum, right? Why didn't you do this and y'all knew Thanos was coming? They knew Thanos was coming. Why in this moment you want to do it just because you want Planet Titan? And you didn't want to go and check time before? Because this is the thing about it. He used the stone so late in time. At this moment. To where now the outcomes have changed. If he did this earlier, they could have been changed that motherfucking outcome, bro. They could have changed it. Because it's the specific place in time where you look at these outcomes. And that's how it's going to play out. If he did this earlier when they were on Earth, would have been a totally different outcome than this. Why at this moment you choose to do it just because you're on Titan now? You could have easily made a portal to go home if you're talking about saving the Infinity Stone, which you're not. You guys put it in further danger. And you're listening to Tony. Yo, man, we need to take this Infinity Stone straight to Thanos' front door, you know? Let's put it inside the gift box. Let's wrap it up. Woo, 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 woo. Give it to Thanos, and here you go, Thanos. Wee! That's basically what this was, bro. That's whack. That's just, like, you can do cliches. But when you do cliches like this, this dumb stuff, this cliche dumb stuff, and it happens so repeatedly, just because you got a cliche and other people are doing it, don't mean you safe, bro. You repeatedly doing something else that is copied and repeated and fatigued. It's like a scary movie, bro. That same thing where that white girl slips over nothing. How? How did you slip? Are you okay? How did you slip, baby? How did you slip? But this 14,605 possibilities, ways, blah, blah, blah. Total bullshit they wrote in to make a sequel. Because this is the reason why they're even able to make a sequel. Because Doctor Strange has the time stone, right? So Doctor Strange being him, already making dumb decisions by listening to Tony Stark that he just met the first day. He just met Tony Stark this movie. And now he's over here like, alright, I'll listen. And he was over here just earlier talking shit like he's a mad shit, bro. What happened? What changed? Just because Tony sees Thanos in his head? Shut the fuck up. No one's listening to this paranoid fuck. He made Ultron. And we're listening to him. I'm not saying dismiss him. But for rationale, we're listening to Tony to be rational. Go ahead and take the stone of Thanos. Put it on his front doorstep. Smart. Makes sense. But this is total plot bullshit that they wrote in to have a sequel that's unnecessary. These guys have the ability to kill Thanos as is. The time stone freezes time. Why don't you freeze time, chop off his head, and dip? Right? Do not give this character Doctor Strange a time stone, and he ain't finna do nothing. Miss me, bro. And I get this movie has a theme of sacrifice. That's the theme. But, we're gonna see it later in the movie where where Doctor Strange saves Tony when he could have easily sacrificed his whack ass. Freak Tony Stark, bro. So I hate this motherfucker. Get him out of here in the MCU, bro. He needs to go. I'm ready for them after Avengers 4 reboot. Bring in the X-Men or something. Kill off all the Avengers, most of them, and leave some. I don't want Cap to go. I'd rather sacrifice Tony and let Cap stay, bro. But next scene, bro. Next scene. Let's go. Let's dive in deeper into Thanos. Now, this character says something that has me interested. And further why I get into more of freak this movie. This average movie, bro. Watch this.
Welcome, Thanos. Son of Alars.
Who the fuck is Alars? Explain this shit in the next movie. Do not come to me talking about they're making a book. You can buy the book and you can see his origin. No, because that's not going to work for everybody. You got old people. You got young people. You got middle-aged people going to go see this movie. You think all of them finna go pick up a DLC book to get the story of the movie? And his origin should have been explained in this movie, bruh. He should have had an origin. You giving the Guardians, you giving Star-Lord, Drax, Mantis in a more spotlight than Thanos and him? The freak, bro. Freak these Guardians. Get them out of here. Only person that matters is Gamora. That's just real. Only person that matters is Gamora. I want y'all to see some crazy shit, bro. Watch this. Watch this. This bootleg shit, bro. Pull up. Watch this.
It extracts a terrible price.
Is that Mistress Death? Dude, that's Mistress Death.
I'm tired.
Man, we don't need no Adam Warlock, bro. We got this Mistress Death. Let's get it, bro.
We all think that at first. We are all wrong.
Nigga, who is you? Oh, it's Red Skull. Nigga, fuck out of here. Get your ass out of here, my nigga. Freak you, bro. Get the freak out of here, bro. I don't want to see that shit. What was that, bro? That was fishy. Best comic book movie ever. Hold up, bro. Next scene, bro.
This isn't love.
I ignored my destiny once.
He ignored his destiny once. Better be explained in Avengers 4 what that destiny was. And I know that don't got shit to do with Mistress Death.
I cannot do that again.
You cannot do that again. Better be explained in Avengers 4.
Even for you.
Even for you. So, Gamora, since she was willing to die, right? And you knew the location, right? And you didn't want to risk getting caught, right? Why didn't you just, you know, kill yourself earlier? You was willing to die. You could have literally... When Gamora was walking with Mantis and them to link up with Thanos on nowhere. Why didn't she just shoot herself in the head and be done with it, bro? She just shoot herself in the head. Why didn't you just shoot yourself in the hood since you was willing to let your boyfriend, your whack boyfriend, kill you? Why didn't you shoot yourself in the head? Be done with it. Start having that seizure and be done with it. But nah. For a plot, you're gonna let yourself get captured when you was talking about kill me earlier, boyfriend. And you didn't let your boyfriend shoot. Well, your boyfriend did shoot you, but you know, Thanos poop your party. Whack, bro.
I'm sorry, little one.
Thanos freak you, bro. Trying to make us sympathize with Thanos. Trying to make us sympathize. Nigga, shut your ass up. You don't love her. If you loved her, you wouldn't have tossed her off the cliff. You love the Infinity Stones. He loves the Infinity Stones in balance. He does not love her. If you loved her, you would have never killed her mother. If you loved her, you would have never did that to their planet. He doesn't even regret killing half on their planet. How does he love her? How does he love her? Explain that to me. Complicated people like Thanos are the same people that get abused and stay with their abusers. Thanos is that same complicated person. Complicated. Send them to the cliffs, bruh. Launch off the cliff, bruh. Throw your stupid ass off the cliff. That's just stupid, bruh. Talk to you. Face though. We go into the video there. Part 6 is gonna be the last part, and we done with this shit. Cuddy, we done. Part 6. Hit part 6 coming, bruh. I'm gonna premiere this shit. Yo, your boy K-Dot signing out. First Black Super Saiyan to ever arrive on this planet. I'm the first Black Super Saiyan to ever arrive on this planet. You guys. I'm on that first Black Super Saiyan status. Shit. On that first Black Super Saiyan status. But your boy gotta go. SJK.signing out. Doses.